This is the first webinar that we are going to be making, and the idea is to start showing all the new features in this format. The other format that we had, I thought it was a good idea to send all the videos and on the gift, but for the feedback that we have been having, like many people like didn't have time to see it, or it was like just way too much. So the idea is to do on each of the deploys that we do to production with the new version, is to do one of these webinars. We're gonna quickly go over everything we deploy. This should last like about half an hour. And then we can have any questions or whatever you guys want to ask, if that's the case. And also in this series of webinars, what we are gonna be doing is doing maybe at the beginning like weekly, and then we might do bi-weekly or depending how it goes. But we are gonna go on each of the features of Mylenio in detail. So we are gonna do a webinar on just documents, a webinar on flows, webinars on teams, webinar on permissions. The idea is for everyone to have something simple that they can watch anytime they want, and they can take like the most of the application as possible. Well, the first features that we're going to be showing is open positions and the recruitment module. And this is a new module that everyone should have on the site right now. If for some reason you are not seeing this module, you can go to roles and you can assign the recruitment module to the super admin or to the user that you have. And then everyone should start seeing this recruitment module. The recruitment module is the first module that we have done for managing and tracking the open positions and candidates on the company. And it's a module that we are going to be working a lot over time. Basically, and I'm going to do a quick demo on how this works. So you have the open positions on the company, and you also have the candidates for those open positions. These are for the position that you're looking for something. So we can create one, and we can put React.js. Level is going to be levels 3. All these employee levels, this is configurable in settings. And you can assign this to a client or not. But no, I think client is required. But so we're going to put this on Damon Mifflin here. And you can also assign a team. Like, I don't know, if you know that this person is going to go work to one team in particular, you can also group this by teams. Who's going to be the assignee? It's going to be Michael Scott. You can put an external code if you want, some description on what this guy is doing. And then move this. There you go. And this is going to create the position. So now we have a React.js position on the company and the employee level is level 3. You can check here the data, and as always on the sidebars, you can change everything that you need. And another thing that you can quickly do is like something that happened several times is like, I don't know, you need like 3 positions for the same thing. So you have this button to quickly duplicate it. So you can change the name. Maybe you leave everything the same and you can create. That's going to create another position just with the same information that you have on there. It's like a fast way of doing a copy paste. So the second important component on this, and also you can see like you have like the hidden position and closed position. This is depending on the status of the position that we're gonna be showing later, but you can have like the position can be active, closed, cancel or archive. And there is not really any logic regarding any of those. It's more about like what you like to have. And as you see here, I have a closed position. Closed positions are being shown on the main screen for like 2 weeks after close. So you can see like what we have been closing on the last days. So the second part of this is the candidates. And the candidates, here you can manage this. This is like a Jira, like a small, actually like a small Trello where you can add new columns and you can sort the columns if you want. You can move them around and move people on different columns. This is gonna show where in your process that person is. So by default, we are putting like these 4 columns, but you can edit and you can add new columns as to match your process. Like, I don't know, can be the person is first pending, then goes to the first interview, then to the second interview, then, I don't know, it's either rejected or done. That's all depending on your HR process, but this is like fully customizable, so that's up to you on how that works. So I'm going to create a new candidate. This is going to be called short webinar, and this is going to be martinshowweb@mylenio.com. Here you can put the description, you can put different tags. You can create like this tag LinkedIn, or you can like put as many tags as you want. You can select what positions that person is applying for. They can be applying for like several positions on the company. You have all the personal information. I'm not gonna fill everything, but we put like all the information that we think you should be tracking for a candidate. But if you're missing anything, of course, you can let us know. But we have the birthday, phone, residence, website. And we also have like more information about what the user is applying for, like what level is applying, what is the referral position, the country that he's going to be working, the branch of the country if you have like multiple branches, like depending if your company have like several companies in each country, you can like be applying to one of those, or you can leave everything blank if you want. And you can also complete the current salary. This will be the expected salary. It could be the minimum and the maximum that the person is expecting. You can fill all this information, and also you can put the CV of the user. Finally, the only thing required is the recruiter. So I'm gonna create a new one. And this is called Sean Webinar. From here again, you can keep adding information if you have more information for the person. And then the user is gonna start flowing on your process. Like now this is an interview. After you finish the interview, you can move it to in process. And if you click there on the user, this is like a card for the user. And you can actually, like, you will have all the information from the user, like the position they apply, the salary that they want, the office that they are applying, and you can put comments here. Just one. And this is useful, I don't know, like after you go to an interview, you want to track some information or you talk with him. And the idea is for here to have all the information related to this person in the same place. So everyone can be aware of everything. Something else that you can do with this, you can share these ones. So this is like a share candidate. It's like a similar screen to the other, but like, this is a link you can share with anyone on your company or outside the company. This does not require you to be logged into the application. And of course, we're not showing the salary on this. We're just showing a reduced version, but this is what at least in our case, this is what like the interviewers get. Like they want to see the person first. They want to see the comments. They want to see the CV if the CV is available. So this is like a view that you can share. Then at some point on the process, if this candidate might be a good fit, you want to start like the offer process. So I'm going to show here, you can click on send offers. And like the idea is you can manage the offers directly from the system. If you see here, like the email too is going to go to, this is their personal email. So we can set a start date. I don't know, it's going to start like next week. And the salary is going to make like $80,000 a year. Well, that's more money, good for him. And what you can do is you can customize this message. And let me show you how that works, because this is something important to configure. When you go to settings in general in the company, there are some new fields with this release where you can actually configure some stuff. So this is a default message that we're gonna be using for all the offers. And you can override this for each of the persons. You can also use this variable for like the amount, for the starting date, and for the name of the person. So this is a default email configuration. I recommend you to go there and put something nice. This is a super important part on the process, where like you can like tell them why you want them on your company. So it's kind of good to dedicate some time. So I'm gonna, you can preview this, and this is gonna show you how they are gonna see on the email. So you can see the dates and you can change something if you want. And the other thing is you can attach a contract. Let me put an offer. One second. Let's hope the mails works, because sometimes it takes a few seconds to get the emails. I'm gonna show you another email that I already have from other demo. So this is the email that, here I have the new email. This is a new email. Hi, Sean Webinar. We are excited to offer a place on this company. And this is all the information that we complete there. So they can click and they can review the offer. This will be the candidate view. So here you can put your own logo to customize this for your own company. And this is what the potential employee is gonna see. He's gonna see all the information, how much he's gonna be making, the starting date, the growth, the message that you put there, and he can either decline it or like send you a comment why he doesn't want it, or he can accept the offer. So let's say accept offer. This is gonna be using DocuSign if you have it enabled, and if not, it's gonna be using your own sign-in service that is like download a file and uploading the file, like everything on that you already have. So they will sign the document. This takes a few seconds for DocuSign to get it, and they have a welcome message. Welcome. Office is the name of this tenant, so this is going to be welcome to Lenio Labs or welcome to Drixit or any company that you have. And like, thank you for accepting the offer, and they will contact you as soon as possible. On this other end, there are a few things that are happening. Here you see that the offer is already accepted. And so you can see on the candidate what candidates have accepted your offer. And another thing is like the person that is the recruiter, he's gonna get a notification, in this case on Slack. I'm gonna show the Slack connection later, but he's getting a notification on Slack that the person accepted the offer, so you can keep going with your own process. Here you can see all the offers that you sent to this person. In this case, this is only one, but if they rejected, you will have like all the list of the history of offers and how those went. And also you can, you can also see here, like in candidate offers, all the list of all the offers that are pending or accepted on the company. So you can have a quick view of everything that is going on this. So without having to go to each of the candidates and seeing how everything is working. One other thing that I didn't show on this, but you will see like if he didn't accept the offer but opened that link, we are gonna show you a counter of how many times he saw the offer. That's kind of nice to see if they open like 20 times and didn't answer, they might be thinking about it. So you might want to call them or like anything you want to do for them to accept. After this, you can actually, so you can close a position. And this is not automatic when they accept the offer because we want to give everyone room to do whatever you guys want. But you can tell that this person is closing this position. So if you go to open positions, this one now is closed. It's gonna show there for like 2 weeks, I think. And after that, it's gonna go only to the closed positions. We are leaving this for 2 weeks because like it's like usually after like just on the moments people close the positions, it's kind of good to be able to see it for a while. And the last thing regarding this module is the convert to user. So you finish, you hire the person, and now you want to create a new user based on this. So we're creating a new user based on this, and what this is doing, this is gonna allow you to create the new user. You can like, maybe you already have it on Google, and this is the second feature, the second important feature is like the user creation. Let me get some water. This is the user creation, so maybe you have it on the directory, and you can select an existing user if you wanna do it that way. But something new that we have done, we have integrated with Google on the user provisioning. So you can actually create users directly from here, and those users are gonna be on your directory created automatically. So let's go over that. So So we're gonna put Martin. Fill in some stuff. You can fill, this is also new on the user creation. These are all optional fields, but you can actually complete all the information that you have on that employee, that new employee. So you can complete the birthday. And remember that we store all this information in Google directly. I can show that later, but you can put like a short job title, employee ID 4444, like contractor. Email, and you can complete anything you want on this. This is also something new that is important. You can assign a manager to the user. This manager is going to be used for the holiday request approval. That's something that we're going to see later too. So, and this is the same as always. You put the vacations. You have this new field here that is going to be for a team. And what this is doing, I'm going to put Argentina, and it's going to be a developer. What is this is doing is like, give me 1 second, so we're gonna invite the user. What we are doing here is like, we are creating a new user and we are gonna invite them to the application. This is gonna send an email, so let me put save and invite. So what this is doing, don't remember, some webinar. Okay, this is the user from webinar here. And they should be receiving a new email. There you go. Remember, all this is from the employee side. So you create a new employee and you send them the login. You can also like create the employee and not send them the login. And that way they are not going to be able to log into the system or do anything. But I'm showing this case now. 1 second. So they will get the login. They will get the password for their user on Google. They have to accept the terms and conditions on Google. Put a new password. And the first screen they see, again, this is configurable per your company. And they're gonna have to do a little activation on this, and we are forcing them to put a photo. And then we are asking them to complete like the basic forms and information. And something also new on this is that they have some onboarding question. This is question one or two. Let me say answer one, answer two. I'm gonna save the changes. And after this, finally, the user is on board. So if we go here again, we can see this is the Sean webinar. He's already on the company, and you can see the answers to the question that you want them to ask. Something important on this. So we create a new user and we invited that user. So that user is now able to join Mylenio. And in that way, they are able to join your company. There are a few other things that happen in that regards because we added them to the Argentina team. Like one of the steps that we put is like add this user to the Argentinian team. So if you come here, here is the user. I got lost with all the images. So we said like create this user, and when you get the activation, add it to this team. And this team already have like documents, trainings, and tasks. So what happened is when that user complete the activation, they go to the activation link, they complete all the information. At that point, when we finish, we add it to the team of Argentina. You can configure as many teams as you want. Maybe you want to add it to the Argentinian team. Maybe you want to add it to the developers on this client or to the any other different teams that, that you know that that guy should go. And what the system is doing, like after they submit, they, we create all the documents for them. So we assign all the documents that the Argentinian team has. So now they can go and they can sign the code of conduct and they can sign the NDA. We have all the trainings, we have all the tasks. So this way you can start automating your processes. So we went from having the candidate, the open position, sending the offers, we create a user account in Google from them, and now they have shown the they have shown Milenio, and they can have all the documents automatically assigned to them. They should also be probably receiving a few minutes, like all the emails. Oh no, they're gonna receive that, those on their new email, on the new one that we create for them. So that's the second issue that we deploy on this. Something that I didn't show, but it's how to configure those questions. Like you can go to settings, onboarding form, and here like is a list of questions that you wanna ask every person that joins your company. For what we found on people that wanted to do this and like other stuff that we have been researching, like a lot of people like to do some question to the employees. They're usually like, I don't know, color do you like? What team of soccer do you like? And it's kind of like an introduction for everyone else in the company. So here you can configure, you can remove this if you don't want to use it. And basically the step two on the activation is not gonna, it's not gonna be there. Let me show you something else. There is another new email that you can send now. It's a first day email configuration. That is like the welcome package for that user. So in this case, you gave them access to the system, but maybe they didn't start working on your company again. And that's something you can play with this. Like maybe you want to give them access on the first day that they start working, or maybe you want to give them access, I don't know, 1 week before they start working so they can start completing all the trainings or the, all the documents. All that is up to you. But this is a second email you can send to them where you can put the presentation data. This is like, where do you should present? Like what do, basically what time and day do you start working? The place, who to contact, and some text. This text is also configurable on the settings that we saw so before. So this is just the placeholder. You can actually change and add more information here. And what this is gonna do is it's gonna send, I'm not going to do it now, but it's going to send an email to the user saying like, hey, you need to present, you need to be there on Monday and talk with like who, like whatever. And if you don't invite the user, and that's the other case, there is some case that maybe you just want to create the account on Google, maybe you want to add them to everything, but you still didn't want to want them to join Milenio. So you can, you could create it when you go to new. Let me show you quickly. You can create it here with like invite now. And this is just gonna create the user in draft. When having a user in draft, you can do anything you do with the normal user. You can put it on Teams, you can put it on anywhere, but they will not get any notification until they actually subscribe to the platform and do the onboarding and the activation. Okay, that's basically all on user creation. And let me show you something else here. Something else that everyone was asking for is to be able to edit all the Google information directly from Milenio. And so as you know, we save that information. So we save all this information directly in Google. And we save all this information, let me show you, on the field that you have configured. And before, for a system, you have to go to admin.google.com and modify all this information manually here. And Milenio was fetching all this information when you click on this button or once a day. Now we change that. That still happens. So if you change anything on Google, it's still going to change on Milenio. But anyone that has access to modify users can now come here and it's going to see all the information they see on Google. And they can modify all the information here. And this will be saved on Google directly. So with this and not having to create accounts because you can create it automatically, there's no need anymore to go to admin.google.com to do anything, which is something that everyone was kind of hoping for. But let me show you something else. The last thing that is important on users is we put the concept of external users, and external users are people are not your employees or contractor, so you don't want them to have full access to the system. So I'm gonna put external webinar. I'm gonna keep using my mail. Webinar.maildenio.com. And here you can say like, I want to invite these people, and I want to allow them to log into the application. This is also like optional. Maybe you want to create external user because you want to just to track them and put them on Teams, but you don't want to invite them. So in this case, let me get back. We're getting an email and it's like, hi, external user. Someone has invited you to the office. My office is the name of this company again. So they can receive the invitation and they can accept it. They have to set a password. And then they're gonna have access to a reduced version of the system. In this case, they only have access to team and training. So this is also something new that you can go to configure on the company what external users are gonna have access to. So here I'm saying team and training, but maybe I also want them to do documents. So you save that and they are gonna start having documents. The idea on this is like, you might want to, and this is global so far, so we want to have feedback from people if they want to start like doing per team or maybe per person, different modules. But for now, it's a global setting, so all the external users that you have are going to be able to do stuff on this. And what we find really useful is for like, I don't know, accounting teams or like any external team that needs to do something on your company, so you can share access. But you don't want to show them, I don't know, the directory, because you don't want them to see all of your employees. And maybe you just want to share them like documents and training, because that's, or maybe just documents for the accounting team to do. So again, this is a new feature on the external users, and we would like to hear feedback on how you could use it and what is useful for you too. Okay, give me 1 second. The next feature that I want to show is a Slack integration. And this is the first automatic permission integration that we released. So we are super happy on being able to do it. We want as much feedback as we can from this. So everyone should start seeing a new tab here. That is the apps tab. I'm gonna show something this is a tenant that has more. And so this is something that is coming on the next weeks. So next week we're gonna be putting GitHub, GitLab, Bitbucket, Slack. Well, Slack is already here, but Jira, Trello. So we're gonna be doing a release of one of them at a time. On this release, we release like the whole system and Slack for you guys to be able to see. This tenant already has Slack configured when you click on application Slack, but if you don't have it configured, you will have here an install button that's gonna ask you for the permissions that we need to connect the application using OAuth. And after that, you should see something like this is connected and working properly. There are a few things to configure that I'm not gonna go on the whole detail now. I'm gonna do another webinar just on Slack and all the integrations, but I wanna quickly show like the most important parts. So once you configure an application, you're gonna be able to start like managing all the resources from that application directly from Mailenio. So we connected the Slack channels, so you can now start like seeing all the Slack channels. And this is reading all the Slack channels directly from Slack. This is synchronizing like once a day. And from here, like one of the most important parts is that you can create resources directly. So I can create a new Slack channel. I'm gonna put under Mifflin, and it's gonna be demo webinar 2 because I already did the one. And you have some stuff like I want the channel to be private, some description, external links if you want to override it, what we do, some logo, but I'm going to fill just the basic stuff. And this is going to create a new channel. If you see here, now have the external ID. So that's the ID of the channel in Slack. So that went to Slack and create the channel for us. So there's no need to go to Slack and do everything. This starts making a lot more sense when we release all the applications. So you're going to be you're gonna be able to create like Jira boards from here, Bitbucket repositories, channel groups, like GitHub, GitLab, Trello. So you can create from here everything you need. You can even validate the format and a lot more other like complicated stuff that we're not gonna go now. But the main idea, my idea on this is that you can assign those resources to teams. This is a new tab that you guys are gonna start seeing now. So I'm gonna show this too. I'm gonna put demo webinar 2. And this is the same type of UI that you have with document task and training. Now you have to, but this is like with permissions. So this is a Slack channel, demo webinar 2. And we are gonna say like, who is gonna have access to this? I'm gonna say the account manager and the project leaders. So if you see, I'm here logging as the account manager. And now I have a notification from Slack saying that my Lenio invite me to this channel. And if you can see here, you have Michael and Dwight. My Lenio is the application. It's gonna be on all the channels that you create and everything. So let's touch again. Let's input the people on DevOps. That's gonna add Kevin Malone. So if you come here, now you have Kevin Malone on Slack. And you can, we're gonna remove these two people. I'm gonna only leave Michael on that channel and they should be gone. Now they're gone. So basically with one click on linking the Slack account, you can start creating channels, you can modify the channels, you can invite people, you can remove people. And this is all based on teams. And why this is so important is because like usually for your own teams, I don't know, you have a team for a project. So that project has they have their own Slack channels. Maybe they have a Slack group with some of the people on the team. Maybe they have a Jira board. Maybe they have a drive in Google that they have to have access, or they have like some repository, Bitbucket or GitHub or GitLab. So here you will model everything on that, how it works, like who should have access to what. And then when you start like onboarding people to the team, so if I put someone new here, not gonna do it now, but you can put like a new employee that just joined the company, that person is automatically going to be added to all the document training and tasks. This was already happening on your system, but they're gonna be added to all to everything on your stack. So right now, like the only connection that you're gonna have is Slack, but like on the next weeks, we're gonna start releasing all the other things. So basically you can like just do one click, this work for mobile and everything. You can do one click on someone, add to this team, they should have access to everything without you ever touching anything on permissions. This is like a huge time saving. And we have been using this for like more than 1 year internally. And we think this is one of the features of Mylenio that is gonna have like the most potential of all like during the next time. There are a few other things on here that you can do. Like, so this is integrated also with a bot that you can talk with the bot. So I don't know, I wanna see my documents. And this is gonna show me all the document that I have pending. So I'm gonna say, yeah, you have one document that is pending. So like take 1 second to go there. You can click there and this is gonna go there and it's gonna be able to sign it. You can check the task, you can check some other stuff that I'm not gonna show everything now, but you can also do recognitions. So before people have to go to the application to do recognitions, if you connect Slack, you can do the recognition from here directly. You can click the users or teams that you want to recognize. Testing webinar. And what this is doing, this is gonna send the recognition on the system. So we are gonna see that on Mylenio, but you can optionally make it post on a channel. So it's, hey there, Mike Scott just recognized Dwight for inspiration and for like testing the webinar. And if you see here, you also have that recognition, but also went to the channel. And this is really important because this gives like visibility for everyone on your company. You can put this channel recognition, you can put it on the team that you have everyone on the company. So everyone on the company is gonna be here. So like when someone recognizes someone, everyone can see it and they can start like sending emojis and they can start like giving everything to them. You also see here like some emojis like that I don't have installed in this Slack, but I wanna show this to you. So you can click on install emojis There is no way to do this automatically, but we are giving for free all of our emojis for you to have. These are all the Lenny emoji, and Lenny is like the mascot of the project. So you can basically download all the emojis and go to Slack and upload them if you like them. Like we found out people like really like to have some custom of this emoji, and they are there for you to use if you want. You can just click on one and download it. You can get the Lenny beer. Okay, and let me show you something else on Slack. So what we did with the recognitions, this is something you can configure here on the system, like where, what channel you're gonna be using. You don't have to create a new one. If you already have a channel, you can put that the recognitions are gonna be posted to that channel, and that's all. Something important on this is like the user that you use to connect this, first should be an admin on Slack, and second, like my Lenny is only gonna be able to manage like the channels and the stuff that user is part of. So for that, we create like this function. Like if you click here, that this is gonna make your user showing all the public channels that he doesn't belong. And after that, you can start seeing and managing the channels. And for the private channels that you already have, someone will need to invite that person. We do recommend using like a new user, like just for this, and if you're willing to pay that extra seat on Slack. But that can be a user called like, I don't know, like the name of your company on anything, and you put him on all the channels, so you don't use like a normal person. But it will work with a normal person or anything, so that's not a requirement at all. That's basically all on Slack. There are a ton of other things on this that, I mean, I'm not gonna show everything, but you can see the compliance on this. You can do a lot of other stuff, but we don't have time to go over everything. But I'm gonna do a webinar just on permissions probably in the next week or two. And at last, there's also something that most people were asking, is the approval flows. So we put in this new screen. We might move this to some other place later, but for this release, you can go to setting approval flows. And here you're gonna see all of your holiday types that you have, and you're gonna see all of your tasks and all of your requests. And you can configure the flow. Like before on the system, you only have like one approval for each stuff, but everyone was asking, hey, I wanna have like, I don't know, first this person approve it, then someone else. So now for each of these stuff, you can come here and you can create steps. And there is a special tag that is called the manager. So I'm gonna save that. And I'm gonna, So what this means, like if you create it like this, like all the holiday requests that people make with this type of holiday, they're gonna have this flow. First, Michael Scott is gonna approve it, then the manager, and the manager is the person that you configure as manager on the user edits that we configure. And then after that, Dwight is gonna approve it. So basically by changing the flows here, and you can do it for each one of those, you can have like different approval for different parts on the applications. And this is also really useful, I don't know, for like the holiday. First you got the manager approve it because that's the person that's gonna be more affected for with him gone. But after that, you want someone on HR to do something with the days or on the vacations. And then maybe you want someone to do something with the accounting team. So this way you can create your own flows of approval, and they will get all the stuff and assignments for them to do. Okay, so that's all on the, there are some other stuff like small issues, small bugs that we fix, and a lot of other like stuff on more detail that I'm gonna be going on individual webinars, but that's kind of like the most of the stuff that we deploy. And